All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Antonio Rodrigo Minotauro Nogueira and Dan Severn. So here he is, one of the better offensive takedown guys we have in the UFC, DC. And if anyone is well equipped to speak to this, it is you. The opponent knows what's coming. At least to this point in the UFC, no one's been able to stop
him. He just has to keep him away, because the moment this guy gets close enough to either grab a leg or make body contact,
right,
now you're in trouble. He has a knowledge and an understanding of position from a lifetime of just all grappling, judo, wrestling, sambo. He does it all, and he has just so many ways to get you to the floor. This guy once told me that if you can get your leg, he's going to finish.
Right.
Because he's going to give you so many things to think about, you will not be able to process and keep up with him, and eventually you're on the mat. It's unbelievable to watch him apply that knowledge to the mixed martial arts fight.
And as the wrestlers say, this is not a guy you want anywhere near your bracket.
No, you don't want him in the bracket.
All right, well, he's one of the more accomplished Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioners in this division, DC, and I know how many chokes you have in your arsenal. Offensive jiu-jitsu, defensive jiu-jitsu doesn't get much better than this guy.
It doesn't get as high level in terms of jiu-jitsu knowledge. He knows in every exchange that he's the guy that's processing things at a different level. From the armbar submissions that he has shown in the octagon to the beautiful guillotine chokes that he does over and over again. And don't think that he won't roll for a knee bar and get a submission.
Right.
It's just constant danger when you're in the jiu-jitsu with this guy.
And even the high-level wrestlers that he's fought have paused to try to take him down because of that patented guillotine.
It's
so truly a case of pick your poison with this Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner.
Our tale of the day for this, our main event of the evening. The American is 37, the Brazilian is 44. He is 1 inch taller. He will have a 2-inch reach advantage. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Bergliata. Now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a mixed martial artist. He stands 62 inches tall, weighing in at 250 pounds. Fighting out of Coldwater, Michigan, USA, Dan the Beast Severn. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 34 wins, 10 losses, 1 draw, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet 3 inches tall, weighing in at 240 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Antonio Rodrigo Minotauro Nogueira!
All right, mental rules in the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. On a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out.
The fighters touch gloves.
You ready?
Let's fight. So here we go with round one, and fear is not a factor for him. He feels so confident in all of his skills, he don't care what...
John, it doesn't matter. It does not matter how well you see yourself as a grappler. This guy's different level.
Yeah.
This guy's next level. You want to avoid this at all costs. Maintain distance. Do not go and grapple this guy.
Single collar time now, and he landed the right. right hand there. Takedown defense holds up. Engages in a Muay Thai clinch, and I think a lot of people watching wonder how you can control an opponent like that. Hard to get out of.
It's very difficult to get out of. Look at, notice how tight his elbows are as he's maneuvering and moving his opponent into positions where he can get off the strikes.
Throwing that jab yet again out of range. Closes the distance, gets the single collar tie.
Right hand punch to clinch.
Severn's got the tie clinch. Let's see what he can do with it. And they separate. Oh, a little single collar tie there. Looked like he might have landed there. Instead, a swing and a miss by Nogueira. Oh, single collar tie here.
Right hand punches the clinch.
Nogueira's got the tie clinch now.
Ooh, what a punch.
And now he's got that tie clinch. And those knees aren't just for effect. Those are doing real damage. All right, he engages in the single collar tie. Forth we go. He blocks the punch. Seconds left. Single collar tie now. Horn sounds for the end of round one. All right, so there's the end of the round, and on one side, thrill, on the other, agony after that knockdown.
Yeah, he was able to really damage him with that big punch. You see the hands, the speed, how sharp he is, how technical he is. It allows him to land in spots where his opponent is winging punches. Great strike landed, great punch landed to put his opponent down.
Okay, ready? Round two, you ready? Let's go, fight.
Body kick is blocked. Oh, nice connection there with a punch, DC.
Great time to land that punch. Oh, he heard him bad with the jab.
Got the single collar tie.
He gets to the spot, the tie clinch. Then he starts to let the knees fly.
All right, well, he's landed some good shots tonight, but there's no three-piece, there's no soda. More often than not, it's one and done.
He's not even getting a combination. I mean, if you're going to sit, oh, that was a big takedown. Is this the one that's going to break him? Oh, he's attacking choke now.
Oh, beautiful counter there as he gains the side mount and try to get out of this guillotine by potentially attempting a Von Flew. Wow. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom. The kimura is not the arm. It's the shoulder pressure that usually makes you tap.
But now DC trying to isolate an arm.
Yep, he's using the kimura. Oh, now he's in trouble.
Guard. Well, he's staying pretty effective here, fighting off of his back. Nice strike landed there by the bottom by Nogueira. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. accuracy and efficiency with these ground and pound strikes here. And if you're the opponent, you got to intelligently defend or the referee's going
to
stop it.
You got to defend. But you can see him now starting to gain posture and the intensity at which he's throwing these ground strikes is starting to improve. It's starting to elevate because he knows that he can get the finish.
Brilliant submission defense there.
Size control, he's pretty safe there.
Severn, ground and pound from half guard now. Let's see if he can do some damage. Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here. And you understand, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here.
Sever, ground and pound from half guard now. Well, you got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice punch.
Five.
All right, there's the horn, and what a round it was. DC, take us through the replays.
Punch after punch. He landed him at will. He went right at his opponent, got in his face, and showed, this is my octagon. We are going to dance to the beat of my tune.
Forget about that round. Listen to me. You're going to go out there, and you're going to stick to your jiu-jitsu. You're going to take him right there.
You ready?
Third round underway. Oh, high-level defense there. The hook shot is flushed by Severn. So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Nogueira gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here. Oh! Ooh, now he's got the Thai Plum, Daniel. If you're on the other side, what are you trying to do to get out of this potentially dangerous position?
You got to start digging your shoulder to a side and then trying to shove an underhook. You cannot bend down to try to get out of Muay Thai clinch. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's going to shut your body off.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Severn's got the tie clinch. Let's see what he can do with it. Oh, and now the underhook, DC.
He's got the underhook. He's got the far side post. If you're the opponent, you have got to get out of here.
Well, this is exactly the sense of urgency you're looking for. Try to take the judges out of it. He is lighting them up now. He'll engage in a single collar tie. Well, if you like Muay Thai striking, this might be your moment in this fight as he gets the tie clinch.
This is a massive moment for this fighter. He is a great Muay Thai fighter. Look for him to go knee-knee and then try to land a big one to the head.
Oh, collar tie.
Left hand punch with the clinch. Wow. Actually got the takedown. Oh, wow.
Oh, what a beautiful counter to the guillotine there. Gets side mount, and now maybe the Von Flue choke will be there. Ovin St. Preux has got to like that transition there. And that will do it! Take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He does a great job of staying patient. He doesn't rush or panic. You are never safe when you're fighting this guy. You're in a lot of trouble. You're in a lot of trouble the entire time when you're this good in the submissions.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 58 seconds of round number 3. For the winner by submission, Dan the Beast Seller.
Well, the celebration is on in his corner, and hard to blame these guys, sort of waiting to exhale, get a huge win tonight, and not just the win, but they get it by submission.
They knew what they had in front of them. They knew how tough a competitor his opponent was, but they also knew that if they could get this fight to the ground, they could find a submission. They found a submission. He got his hand raised.